We are here at the D.C. Canna Gather in the Adams Morgan neighborhood, and I want to introduce you to my friend, George Martorano. George has one of the most compelling and really excruciating cannabis stories that's out there. George, what's your story?
First, pleasure to be here. We're like two ships passing in the night. I'm only home a short time, a few years, and I heard about this gentleman while I was away. I got his articles and pictures, and to me, you present the right atmosphere, the right feeling. I don't get involved with people for money aspect. I get involved with people that want to help people, and that's what you relate to me. So I always wanted to meet you, and we kept missing each other. So quickly this morning, I'm a runner. I'm running all my life. I hated running in circles. For 32 plus years, I ran in circles in prison. So I ran past the White House. It was ecstatic. As free as an individual, I had my passport in my pocket, and I'm running, and I felt so rejuvenated. And then I got done on the run, and I'm on the corner in the middle of Washington, D.C., ladies and gentlemen, middle of Washington, D.C. I looked up, and I see this guy. He's on his phone, and he has his historical and his braids. I says, could that be Steve DeAngelo? Who has braids today? I walked up to him, and I says, are you Steve DeAngelo? He says, yeah, I'm George Martorano. And that's where, that is profound fate of friendship, ladies and gentlemen. There's supposed to be 900,000 in the city. This is before 8:30 in the morning. And I bumped into this gentleman, and listen to me, I feel good all day about this. Real friend, my brother.
No coincidences, just synchronicities.
Yeah. It's unbelievable. I just want to share that with everyone out there.
How did you keep your center and stay positive during those 32 years?
I don't know. If I answer that honestly, I don't know. It's something. Ladies and gentlemen, we all have something inside us. Okay? It is your core for survival, is your core of hope, as you keep you going. Fortunately, I had something. I used to take it out on a daily basis, look at it, and it kept me going. If I was to answer that in entirety and honesty, it wouldn't be on. I don't know how. It's just, I pray that everyone has that. Pray that everyone. And there's a lot of, listen, first of all, this is a very profound sentence, what I'm going to say. Better men and women have died in prison than I. You know, prison's not about guys. A lot of women have suffered. So better men have died than I. Not about me. It's about setting a message that continues to help others. Steve. Why did I have to struggle? Because, you know, I speak at a lot of colleges. I speak a lot of criminal justice courses. And when I go to criminal justice courses, you know what my title is, Steve? One title. The hardest case to beat is a friend. It's pertinent. Years, decades ago, centuries ago, till today. The hardest case to beat is a frame. When you're framed, they're not going to throw the cronies that did that to you under the bus. You got to write it out. I appealed 32 times. 32 times, the most appealed federal prisoner to date. And am I angry? No. I take a positive and a negative. But the only thing you can do is move forward, Steve, and try to help others. That's all we can do. That's all we can do.
All right, so what's the mission now?
Well, my Cannabis for Guns program, ladies and gentlemen, it's the most innovative movement in the country where we actually take guns from, street guns have no numbers on it. They're sanded off. And every law, basic law in America, has SAM law, small amount of marijuana. So I work clandestinely with retired law enforcement. We go into the hood and we try to trade for guns. And we make sure the guns are smelted. But we want to bring it into a legitimate program. It's on my website, ladies and gentlemen, cannabisforguns.com. It's on my bio page. It explains how it works. It costs nobody anything. nobody anything when we can take tens of thousands of guns across America off the streets. Please, they invite me to cities. I speak in front of City Hall. I told you this morning, standing ovations, then nobody calls.
So could we take that smelted gunmetal and make stuff out of it?
Yeah, you can make anything. You can make
dab tools.
Yeah,
maybe.
Anything. Pipes. Anything.
Grinders.
Anything.
Dab tools.
Anything.
Right? Would you like to buy a grinder or a dab tool that was made from a smelted gun that got smelted because it was traded for cannabis? Sounds cool to me.
You know, it's not about the big things. It's about the little things staying the course. The little things that make sense. Fortunately, unfortunately, I live in Philadelphia, a city that I love. Okay? Fortunately, I got there after doing over 3 decades in prison. Thought I would die there. I'm finally back in the city I love. Unfortunately, the reason I started CannabisForGuns.com is when I got home and I get up very early, I turn on the TV, breaking news every single morning. Multiple shootings. It's Philly, it's Chicago, it's Baltimore, it's etc. And I have an inroad of an innovative movement that it's not going to solve the problem, ladies and gentlemen, but it could make a difference. That's all I'm asking, to try to make a difference. And that's what hurts America. The conservative mindset that says, well, I can't take that extra step because I'm worried about me. And that's the mindset that hurts this country. When the conservative mindset is worried about you, it's not about you, it's about helping others. So I get so annoyed. I'm usually not this emotional, but I'm with Steve DeAngelo. I heard about him and when I was in the cell, he was an advocate for me and he sent overtures. And so, you know, we're just old cannabis soldiers trying to do the right thing.
So
it's not about my suffering, it's about using my suffering to enhance others that come up. And we lost the message in America. It's just that Steve and I and people like us, we're trying to race to the guy, tap him on the shoulder, say, hey, wait a minute, turn around, look. It's not about you. These politicians, they're not all bad, but it's not about them. It's not about them. It's about helping others. And we there's some organizations in place. Believe me, we're a great country in helping others, but we need to do more. My sentence was life, no parole. That means you come out in a body bag. There's no in between. You come out in a body bag. I fought my way out of hell.
Now, this is life without parole for cannabis crime.
Cannabis. My life, no parole count was weed. Just a small amount, 2,600 pounds of a conspiracy. I wasn't even there. It was a conspiracy. It gave me life. Incidentally, ladies and gentlemen, they try to execute me. You go on my website, hiphempcafe.com, Recently, I had an electric chair reconstructed. I wouldn't buy one. You can buy an electric chair online, but I'm not going to buy a chair. They had one for sale, $21,000. It killed 150 people. I'm not going to put that in my cafe. So I simulated an electric chair, and there's a plaque there because the night before I got life, no parole, my judge literally called around the city of Philadelphia, the other judges and lawyers, how the word to execute me. Execute. And when my lawyer told me that, I said, well, listen, get up there and say, you cannot sentence this man. You're totally judicially in conflict. Couldn't do it. That's why I travel today, a lot of colleges, criminal justice courses. And again, that statement is, the hardest case to beat is a friend. Now, I'm George Martorano. I was strong enough, intelligent enough to weather it. But what about the other 10,000, 20,000, 50,000, 60,000? They're just there and they don't know how to come out of it. That's the sad thing. They don't know how to come out of it. They're dying. They're dying on bunks. So we have to move forward. I'm praying. Listen, I would, if I can literally speak in front of the full Senate, the full Congress, as a man, if I can really speak like I'm speaking now, you can kill me in the morning. Just let me express what it needs to be expressed, and you can kill me in the morning, and then my job is done. And hopefully out of that body, that group of people that I talk to, we win some over to our way of thinking.
Thank you, George.
George Martorano and Steve Angelo here at D.C., our nation's capital. So we met, we're here. Yeah,
we're here.
We're going to continue.
Yes, we are.
There's no stopping up. If there's a bud on a plant, they can't stop us.
No. Only one way out of this mission.